Hello, everybody. Merry Christmas. I'm going to show you in detail how I made this Wild Man Christmas nutcracker using paper mache. Join me. Well, let's start off by using this wrapping paper cardboard tubes. The first thing you have to do is sketch out your design in scale of how you want your nutcracker to look like. Now I'm going to use my drawing as a template to scale everything to size. I'm going to start off by creating the base, the stand, for my nutcracker. You have to make this stable to hold your nutcracker. You can see here how I'm using a template to scale the legs onto the wrapping paper tube. Then I'll cut them out and I'll roll them to size. Then I'll use tape to hold their shape. And I'll use this technique to create all the other shapes of the nutcracker. Here's all my pieces cut out and to scale, ready for paper mache. I need to firm up this paper tube, so I'm going to trace it out on this cardboard and cut it out. Now it's time to make the paper mache. I find it easier making small batches of paper mache as needed. So add your flour and mix in your water until you have a nice thin runny mix. Also have all your paper ripped to size and ready to use. Here I'm dipping a strip of paper into my runny mix and wiping off the excess. I'll add one or two layers to the base and let dry before adding more. Now I'm adding a layer of paper mache to the legs and the arms. These round circles that we cut out earlier to firm up the body, we need to cut holes in for ventilation purposes. I'm going to lightly sand the base, the legs, and the arms. This tube is for his body, which I'm cutting in half to create a space for his waistline. Now I'm adding those circles we cut out to firm up the body. I'm using small strips of paper mache to glue the circles to the body, and I'll let that dry. Yes, I know I'm covering up the air vents. After it dries, I'll fix that. Oh no, camera wasn't on. Sorry. What I did was added a small piece between the two body halves to create his waist. And I used paper mache to glue the pieces together. Now we're going to learn how to make paper pulp. Ready? I'm mixing the paper pulp with some flour and water as a binding agent. I'm now adding it to the top of his body to round off his shoulders for his head to sit on. And I'm also using my X-Acto knife now to open up those air vents in his body. After it's dried, keep sanding those layers. You want those layers to be nice and smooth. Sanding's your best friend. This is where all the paper pulp comes in handy. I'm now using it to fasten the legs to the body. I'm packing it in to make everything one piece. Now I'm standing it upright to make sure the legs and the body are straight. Now I'll let it dry. Time to work on the arms. I'm adding pulp to the tops of the arms and shoulders and rounding them off. I'm also rounding off pulp on the lower part of the arms as hands. I place two more circles inside the head and I'm using strips of paper mulch to bond them together. Paper mache, not mulch. Here I crunched up some paper and placed it on top of his head as a filler. Now I'm adding some paper pulp to round off the top of his head. The hat's done. Place the hat on his head and move it around to see which angles look the best on his head before using the paper mulch to bond them together. Paper mache, not mulch. Attaching legs to the base, I'm using the paper pulp to form boots that will attach him to the base, and I'll let it dry. Covering the pulp, we put on his shoulders with paper mache, getting ready for his head. Attaching the head with strips of paper mache. Attached his arms using Gorilla Glue. You still with me? We're gonna get this done. Let's finish. Off camera, I added a nose and a box-shaped mouth. Now I'm painting with a latex primer. Important to lightly sand after paint dries. At this point, you have a finished nutcracker, ready to be painted and decorated the way you want. I'm turning mine into something different. A Wild Man Christmas nutcracker. I have a white piece of vinyl I cut the shape for his mouth. I'm using a permanent marker to draw his teeth on. Then I'll glue it into the square box. Thank you. This hole I'm drilling goes in less than a half inch into his hollow body as an air vent.
Here he is, all wild for Christmas.